Hey, welcome to the shop. Today I'm going to be comparing three of the most popular portable bandsaws that are on the market today. I have a Milwaukee and a DeWalt that are both available for right around $300 on Amazon and other places right now, as well as a Bauer from Harbor Freight that is available for $140. Right now there's a coupon for $100. So let's get into it and see how these things stack up.
Let's start off by looking at the features. Now as far as handles go, here on the Milwaukee, two fingers will fit there on the trigger and two below, which gives you a reasonable grip, especially since there's this bolster here on the back to help hold up. Now the front handle is nothing special, but it does the job, gives you something to hold on to. The Bauer is a very similar arrangement with two fingers fitting on the trigger and two below, and it also has that bolster up there on the back to help provide some additional support. The front handle, again, is very similar on the Bauer, gives you something to hang on to. Now, the DeWalt is a different arrangement. Three fingers really fit below the trigger there and one on the trigger, and it has a rubberized grip that continues all the way up over the top there to give you a sure hold. Now, one place that it really stands out is this front handle, where it's a large grip for your whole hand to fit all the way around and give you really sure hold of the tool while you're working. And they went one step further with this thumb screw you can loosen and reorient the handle to be able to work better for whatever's comfortable for you or whatever will fit in the space that you have for a particular job. I thought that was really well thought out on the DeWalt. Now, one place that the Milwaukee really shines is with the LED light, and not only does it illuminate your work area, but you can see the shadow there where it shines directly through the blade and gives you an idea of where you're going to cut. The DeWalt here, you can see, has a very similar feature that works just as well, but as far as the Bauer, you'll be left in the dark on this one. So let's take a look at the variable speed control. They all have a dial for variable speed up here. You can adjust depending on the type of material or cuts that you're going to make and be able to turn it up and down. So that works pretty much the same on each of the saws. One thing that really stands out though here on the Milwaukee, you can hear there's variable speed from the trigger in addition to the variable speed from the dial. So you set your speed from the dial, but you can still run it slower by pulling gently on the trigger, and this can be helpful when you're getting started with a cut and want to ease into it. Here on the Bauer, you're just going to get all or nothing with regards to your power. When you pull that trigger, there's a pretty good click, and it engages with whatever speed it's set to. Now, the DeWalt also has variable speed from the trigger, and in my opinion, the DeWalt was the most controllable of any of the saws. It had a really nice ability to run slow or fast, regardless of the setting, just by adjusting with the trigger. Now, the guide on the Milwaukee is really well thought out with this button right here that lets you slide it up and down without using any tools, so you can do that in no time at all, but it does move around a little bit. Now, on the Bauer, you need to use an Allen wrench to loosen these two screws in order to move the guard in and out. And the guard is a stamped sheet metal piece, and you can slide it in and out just as you see here, and then tighten it down wherever you need it for the job that you're doing. Now, if you do want to store it in the case, you're going to have to retract that back whenever you put it in the case, so you better keep those Allen wrenches handy. Now, looking at the DeWalt here, it is similar to the Bauer in that it has two screws to loosen. However, the guard is much more heavy duty and more secure there on the DeWalt. And they did think through taking an Allen wrench and attaching it to the cord so you'd have it handy whenever you needed it, but you're still going to need to fumble around with those screws in order to make an adjustment there, and it does take a little time. So here, looking at overall construction, on the end caps, I was surprised to see on the Milwaukee that they're plastic all the way around. So let's flip it over here, and you can see these molded plastic pieces. They do have a double thickness there to give you a little bit of impact protection, and it may be better than the other arrangements, or worse, I'm not sure. On the Bauer here, you have rubber end caps that are sitting over the die casting that's part of the main body. So you have metal right here, and it's covered with some rubber bumpers in case you drop it or to make it easier to set down. You have the similar rubber bumpers here on the DeWalt, though they are slightly thicker, and the die cast material that it sits over is thicker. One unique feature as far as the end caps go on the DeWalt is that there are these fasteners here so you can remove this whole end cap. So if you did drop it and cracked that metal, you could potentially replace it there without losing the whole saw. Now, here, let's take a look at the blade change procedure. I put these all together because they all have pretty much the same procedure. You just pull a lever there to loosen the blade and flip it over, and you can pop the blade in and out without removing any guards or anything like that. It's very quick to be able to replace the blades on these saws, and I wouldn't say that any one stood out compared to another. Now let's look at the overall cut capacity right here. You have a 5-inch depth by a 5-inch width here on the Milwaukee that you'll be able to cut. The Bauer stood out here. It has about 5.5, 5.75-inch depth, so that with the same 5-inch width. And then the DeWalt here has a similar 5-inch depth and 5-inch width for cutting.
Hey, well, let's go ahead and try these saws out. But before we do, if you haven't tuned in before, my name's Tim. I'm a welding engineer, and I make videos for my side hustle shop in my garage. So if you are just learning to weld or you want some tips or projects to make, be sure to subscribe now. Now, in order to try these out, I'm going to go ahead and cut through some 2-inch tubing that's 1/8 inch thick on the walls. So we're going to try them all and see how fast we get through it. Now, to be as consistent as possible, I've put the same type of blade on each one. It's a Milwaukee blade, and I've turned the speed control all the way up. Alright, so we've looked at pretty much every aspect of these different saws. So which one is the best? That's what we've all been wondering. Well, that depends on what you're going to do. The Milwaukee is super robust and heavy duty. The DeWalt is very well thought out with the features, and you get a whole lot of bang for the buck on the Bauer. Hopefully this gives you the information you need to choose the saw that will work best for your shop. Thanks for tuning in today. If you liked what you saw, go ahead and let me know by hitting that thumbs up below, and we'll see you next time.